Computational scientists who use linear algebra are typically concerned about two things. One is performance. If you spend $30 million on a supercomputer, you don't want to only utilize 5% of that computer because of the way you code. The second thing they're very concerned about is space. One of the things that a supercomputer like that gives you is a lot of memory. And what you want to do is load that memory up with the biggest problem you can fit on it so that you can simulate the largest problem that can be simulated at that particular instant in time. We're going to talk about how to do a matrix vector multiplication with a transposed matrix, but we're going to be very concerned about not explicitly transposing that matrix because then we would have to make a copy of it. So here we have a concrete example of a matrix and two vectors. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at the usual operation of updating y with a times x added to y. So how did this go? Well, we marched through the matrix one row at a time, performing dot products and updating the vector. Now, what if instead we want to do a matrix vector multiplication, but with the transpose of the matrix? Now it's tempting to say, well, we'll just create a matrix B, set it equal to the transpose of A. We actually created a routine for that in week 3. And then we'll just do Y becomes B times X plus Y. The problem with that is that you're going to have to store a copy of matrix A, or rather a copy of A transpose. And the problem is that computational scientists often don't want to spend the space on that. The second problem is the fact that transposing the matrix inherently means reading all of the elements of A and then writing out the result. So notice that there are m times n elements in each of A and B. So you would have to do m times n what are called loads, memory operations. And then you would have to do m times n stores to store B to memory, which are also memory operations. Performing a matrix vector multiplication, we saw, is only 2 times m times n floating point operations. And a little bit later in the course, we're going to discuss the fact that memory operations are much, much slower than floating point operations. So you're going to end up spending all of your time transposing matrix A and very little of your time actually computing. So what we want to do is we want to compute with A transpose without actually transposing it. Now, how can we do that? Well, we recognize that when we transpose A, the first column becomes the first row with which you would then want to do a dot product with vector x. Why not just leave the column alone where it is instead of actually making it into a row? And why not just doing the dot product with that column of matrix A? Then you move on and you do the same thing with the next column of A, which would have been the second row of A transpose, and so forth. On the left, we have the dot product based algorithm for AX plus Y. And notice that we march through the matrix one row at a time. And to make that into an algorithm where we perform A transpose times X, all we have to do is march through the matrix by columns. And notice that the update actually remains exactly the same. There is actually a subtle difference, and the subtle difference is that here A1t refers to the current row of A, while here A1t refers to the column A1 with which you're having to do a dot product. So the transpose here in each of these actually has a subtly different meaning. Similarly, we previously had an algorithm for marching through the matrix by columns for performing AX plus Y. And the key ingredient in that algorithm was an AXP operation. If we start with matrix A and we want to perform an A transpose times X operation, recall that rows of A become columns of A transpose. So if over here we were working with a column of A, what we want to do now is work with a row of A, but we want to work with that as if it's a column vector. There's still an A1 here, but there is again a subtle difference, because here the A1 is really the current row of A which has been transposed. The bottom line is that algorithms for computing AX plus Y can be very easily changed into algorithms for performing A transpose X plus Y. All you have to do is march through the matrix differently, and notice that there is absolutely no need to explicitly transpose the matrix.